Hello everyone, welcome to MSFT Webcast. In this video, I'm going to show you the simple steps to install Enterprise Root Certificate Authority on Windows Server 2019. Remember, this is a test environment created in VirtualBox so you can have an idea about the configuration steps. For this demo, I have one Windows Server 2019 virtual machine and which is a domain controller for mylib.local domain. As you can see, the computer host name is ws2k19-dc01, domain name is there mylib.local, and the IP address which is assigned to this server is 172.18.72.5. You can install the ADCS role on a domain controller if you are running a small network, but a separate server is always recommended. And as we are going for the testing purpose only, that's why I'm going to install ADCS role on my domain controller. Again, I'm repeating, it is recommended to install your certification authority role on a separate server. On this server, already I have logged in as a domain administrator, which is also a member of Enterprise Admin Group. And that's why we have a sufficient privilege to install and configure Enterprise Root Certification Authority on this server. In the first step, we are going to install Active Directory Certification Service on this server. To do that, let's click on Manage, select Add Roles and Features, click on Next on Before You Begin screen. We need to select role-based or feature-based installation. Let's click on Next. Here, we are going to install this role on our local server and that is selected by default. Let's click on Next. On this console, we need to select Active Directory Certificate Services. Let's select checkbox. It is going to ask you that it will add certain other features which are required by Active Directory Certificate Services. Click on Add Features to include them as well. Click on Next. Next again. And on this console, you can read brief overview information about Active Directory Certificate Services. Let's click on Next. Now here it is asking us to select the role services which you are going to install on the server. By default, certification authority will be selected and which is necessary to deploy a certificate authority. If you want web-based enrollment for your certification authority, that time you can select this checkbox. Certification authority web enrollment and which we are going to also include in this installation. Let's select it. It requires IIS services, that's why it is asking us we need to install IIS services as well. Let's click on Add Features to add it. Click on Next. Here, you can read a brief overview information about web server role, which is IIS. Let's click on Next. We don't need to add any additional role services for IIS. Simply, we can skip this by clicking on Next button. Let's click on Install to start the installation process. The installation will take a few minutes and when the installation completes, click on the Configure Active Directory Certificate Services on the destination server link. So let's click over there. It will start Active Directory Certificate Service Configuration Wizard. On this wizard, as you can see, already our credential is selected, mylib/administrator account, which is needed to configure these services. Let's click on Next. Here, it is asking us to select the role services which we want to configure. As you can see, the last four boxes are grayed out because we haven't installed them on this server. Let's select a certification authority and certification authority web enrollment. Let's click on Next. Now here, you have to select the type of CA which you want to deploy. For this demo, we are going to use Enterprise CA. Remember, to deploy Enterprise CA, Active Directory is necessary. Let's click on Next button. Here, it is asking us to specify the type of CA which you want to deploy. For this demonstration, we are going to select Root CA. Let's click on Next. On this console, we need to specify the type of private key. We don't have an existing private key. That's why we need to select Create a New Private Key. Let's click on Next. Now here, it is asking us to specify the cryptographic options for your certification authority. We're going to use the default cryptographic provider and I'm going to change the key length, which will be a 4096 bit. And we're going to use SHA-256 hash algorithm for signing certificate. Let's click on Next. Here, you can specify the common name for your certification authority, but I'm not going to do that because this name is very identical to remember. MyLab is the name of our domain, then we have a name of our server, then we have a CA prefix. So this means domain name hyphen server name hyphen CA will be the common name of your server, and that's why I'm not going to change it. If you want, you can specify the common name for your certification authority as per your requirement. I'm going to click on next. Now here it is asking us to specify the validity period for your certificate authority. We're going with the default selection, which is 5 years. Let's click on next. On this console, we need to specify the database locations. We're going to use default location for our certificate authority. Let's simply click on next button to continue. These are the options which we have selected to deploy certificate authority on this server. Click on configure to start the configuration. This will take just a few seconds to complete, and when it's done, you should have some green validation checkbox. That means your configuration has been completed successfully. Let's click on close to close this console, and let's click on close here to close this console as well. Now I can say that we have successfully deployed Enterprise Root Certificate Authority on Windows Server 2019. Let's verify that as well. First of all, I'm going to open Certification Authority Management Console. To do that, you need to click on Tools and select Certification Authority. Fine, this is the console from where you can manage your certificate authority. Here you have a plenty of options. We have deployed Enterprise Root Certification Authority. That's why we have options to manage certificate templates. Here, all those certificate templates will be available, which your CA can assign. Here you can find field requests if you have any. Pending certificate request will be displayed here if you want to manually approve that request. Issue certificate will be listed here and the revoke certificate will be listed here. If you click on this MyLab certification authority name, right click on it and go with the properties. Here you have a plenty of other options which you can use to manage your certificate authority. For example, policy modules are there. Auditing options are there. If you have configured recovery agent, that time that archive key will be listed here. But as of now, we have just deployed the certification authority. That's why all those options are with default settings. And right now, we are not going to change it. We have also deployed a web enrollment for our certification authority, which we want to see as well. So let's open web browser. And in a web browser, we need to specify the URL HTTP. /, and then you can use the name of your server or you can specify localhost /certsrv will be the name of that directory as well. Let's press enter key. And now here you can see it is not asking for authentication because we are accessing on a local computer. And now from this console, we can request a certificate or we can view the status of a pending certificate request. Let's click on request a certificate. And here we have options to create and submit a request to the CA. In short, I want to say now we have an Active Directory web enrollment service in a place so we can create and submit request to our CA to download certificate using a web enrollment. And we also want to check from our client computer that whether our client computer can request for certificate or not. Let's go to our Windows 10 client computer. This computer is a part of our Active Directory domain. Let's log in as a test user 1 on this computer. Once you log into your Windows 10 client computer, let's open Microsoft Edge web browser. Let's specify the URL http://ws2k19-dc01.mylab.local/certsrv. This is the host name of our domain controller /certsrv will be the URL. And now as you can see, it is asking for username and password. Let's specify the password of our user 1. And here we go. So we can see that even now standard user, our domain user can also request for certificate by using this web enrollment website. That concludes our video demonstration on how to deploy Enterprise Root Certificate Authority on Windows Server 2019. Thank you all for watching this video.